Today on Tough Crowd, I'll be showing you the filmmaking tools and lights I keep in my grip cart. I didn't have a teacher or a friend show me what to buy, and everything I know is from the internet or trial and error. I'll point out what's worth buying for your grip kit and what to avoid wasting money on. First things first, tie downs keep everything in place while I'm moving this shit around, and they're always handy on set. My stands are a big disorganized mess. I need to buy a bag or something, and I'm currently looking at something like this on B&H for 27 bucks. This big boom stand lets me set up a hair light for 3-point lighting. It's awesome, but it's also big and heavy. Right now I'm holding the green screen, but we'll get to that later. I've got one heavy-duty light stand with me for setting up tall lights. This is a 5-way reflector. Pretty common in photography, useful in video too. Extension cords. Bring more than you need because even that won't be enough. This is a sandbag used to keep the boom stand in place so that it doesn't topple over when you've got a heavy light on there. Light stands are great because they're cheap and light, but I wish I had just purchased C-stands. They're really what I need and they would replace a lot of this stuff. So that mirror in the background is pretty annoying and distracting and dumb for a video like this, so I went ahead and set up the green screen to show you all what's in that green screen bag. This is a cheap one I got on Amazon. I don't recommend it. The screen itself is nice, but the stand that holds the green screen in place is shit. Milk crates are amazing. They can be used as a chair, a stand, a box. They're lightweight. They're mandatory. This is an office organizer box. In there I've got some C47s, also known as clothespins by people who aren't douches, dry erase markers, different kinds of tape, some tie downs, stuff like that. This is a professional part organizer. You could get this kind of thing at Home Depot for like 10 or 20 bucks. A small bubble level, a Leatherman, post-its, batteries, different sizes, tie downs, Velcro, C47, rubber band, 1-inch clamps, different kinds of tape, USB charger for the wall, you never know. This little storage box is full of bigger clamps, so 2 inches, 3 inches, different kinds of tape, more tie downs. This box says audio on it. It's full of my audio stuff. DSLR Rode mic, lav mic, stereo recorder with a dead cat, wires, random audio stuff, diffusion paper for my lights. Here's my clapper board. On the back, I keep a gray balance card, a yoga mat. Boy oh boy does this come in handy when you don't want to be on your knees all day. Some small light stands, pretty standard. Alright, let me talk about the bigger box on the bottom for a second. If I had a third milk crate, I could fit almost everything I have in the 3 milk crates. I only bought the box because my light stands don't fit in a milk crate, but I'm already putting the longer light stands that I bought recently on the very top. So I should really just buy that B&H bag, get all my longer items in there, and then just have a couple milk crates and it won't look so big and so silly. For now, I'm gonna keep using the box because it works and, you know, until I get more stuff, I don't need to spend that 27 bucks. I'll just keep using the dumb looking box. When I first got into photography, I bought a cheap tripod on Amazon and it was convertible into a monopod. And the monopod part is pretty much all I use now. A small portable level. It's also magnetic. 2 cheap softboxes that I got on Amazon, but they work pretty well. The softboxes came with some diffusers. At Walmart, I picked up some warm LEDs. They're not really film quality, but you'd be surprised how good they look with a little diffuser on them in the softbox. I own CFLs, and I don't really recommend them. I think they look alright, but they're a real pain in the ass. LEDs are just better. Here's a cheap on-camera LED that I bought when I first started. Came with some filters, and I use hooks and loops to keep those attached to the back, so I've always got them. I own 2 real LEDs for film. The first is this wand. Wands are awesome, especially if you also do photography and you want to be a little bit more mobile with your videos. They're just so portable and they're pretty cheap too. This one that I have, I'll put a link in the description, is bi-color, both warm and daylight. The second LED I have is a disc shape and it's what I use as my key light. It is my favorite light. It's also fairly affordable compared to other lights, and if I was more serious I would have something a bit more expensive, but if you're just starting out, you're looking for some cheap solutions, getting 1 or 2 of these LEDs, maybe those soft boxes also, it's a good solution. I can light up most scenes pretty well. Obviously I've got all the wires and everything for all these different lights. The Dolly is a Costco brand. Not to be confused with Costco, the store, where I bought the Dolly for $100. It's convertible 3 ways, it does these cool 3 positions. Very nice for going up and down stairs, keeping everything organized, and in a pinch, or when audio doesn't matter, you can use it to roll around on set too. So there you go, my grip cart. Thanks for watching. If you have any tips of your own, any questions, feel free to leave a comment. Until next time, this is Tough Crowd.